Daigwe ituno, kena atia ono. Greetings, sisters and brothers. I'm Chief Roberto Mucaro Borrero of the Taino tribe of Guainia on the island of Boriquen. And I'm here today to answer the call to unite with a very special conversation with two members of the Grammy Award-winning band, Portugal the Man. I'll be speaking with John Gurley and Zachary Crothers, and we'll be discussing some of their initiatives to support indigenous peoples around the world. John, Zach, Mabuika, welcome.
Hey man, how you doing?
All right. It's great to see both of you.
Yeah. How you holding up over there?
We're doing all right. Hanging in there, following the guidelines, sheltering at home, and doing the best we can to keep our end of the bargain, you know?
Yeah, totally. Yeah, keeping safe.
So I wanted to ask you both, how do you feel Portugal the Man is answering the call to unite?
I think this is a very special time, just amid this, in the midst of this pandemic. I think that there is a positive lining to this. In the kind of isolation and seclusion, it kind of gives you a little bit of a break and turns down a lot of the noise that's around. And I think we can really focus on what truly matters to us. And when this, as this starts to die down and things are safe, we have the opportunity to kind of build a new world. And with this, you know, call to unite, that's what we're all about. We're all about connection. And that's why we play music. I think a lot of that is a call back to the land, and which is why, you know, we have our foundation. That's why our cause is, you know, listening and raising up of indigenous voices.
Yeah, this self-isolation, I think the takeaway from all of this is the fact that we're all doing this for the people around us. And that's something we don't do in our daily lives. We're constantly chasing our paychecks, and it is about the people around us. It is about our elders. It's about, I don't want to get my neighbor sick. Like, I don't want to get people sick. I don't want to spread this. And I think that's a good takeaway. It's just being about other people, being about the folks around us, and thinking about each other.
So I don't know if some of the listeners may be aware, but you've been doing some great work while you've been on the road, when you were able to be on the road. And I just wanted to know if you can just share a little bit about land acknowledgement and what that means.
We grew up very close with the Native Alaskan community, and you know, we didn't realize it till we were older, maybe, but it's about respecting the land and the people of it. And so everywhere that we go, we like to share the stage with representatives from the local indigenous peoples of the area, and who, you know, who have been the stewards of that land forever or been displaced there. But we invite them up and just pass the mic. And it's amazing. It's kind of a shared learning experience between us and the crowd. We get to learn about the place that we're on, where we're connecting, and having a good time and talk about the connections before that. The whole goal is for this to be normal. And acknowledging is just the first step, you know, and it's just a way to kind of, yeah, elevate the voice. Now we're in a rock band, man. We just like to turn up the volume on everything. We like it loud.
In doing that, we do get the shared learning experience. Everybody gets to be educated together. We didn't always know. Getting to meet people around the world and getting to meet the peoples of the land that we're on is such a special thing that we get to share with an audience.
Well, John and Zach, just considering the current situation that we're in, facing this pandemic, is there anything that you can share with the viewers to kind of help them out moving through this in a good way?
I would like everybody to recognize the gift that they have for themselves. That's power. And not fake power, not people following you or money or anything like that, or control over somebody else or another people, but the power that comes from you. And in this time, clearly if you're watching this, you care, and you're looking for ways to make these times better and this place better. And I want you to recognize the kind of power that you have. Every single person has the power to change the world for the better. And right now we have time to actually process how we want them to be, because we can write it right now. We can write our future. We can create the world that we walk into when this is done.
Well, you know, you're really given an opportunity for Indigenous peoples, and I'm looking forward to continuing to support you, the band, Portugal the Man. I hope that, you know, we can get out and actually see you guys perform live soon. But I just think that this opportunity to, you know, give people a voice is like, you know, what we've been calling for, you know, a seat at the table. Because if you don't have a seat at the table, you know, you're probably serving those who are, or you're on the menu. So we want to thank you for giving us that voice. And I'm Chief Roberto Mucaro Borrero of the Guainia Taino tribe. And I've been discussing some really important issues with two members of the Grammy Award winning band, Portugal the Man, John Gurley and Zach Carothers. And we're here calling on you all to unite. Thank you very much. Ha home.